So good morning, student. Can you hear me? You can hear. Okay. So today I'll start with the word one of the inorganic chemistry chapter. That is about the dihydrogen. So dihydrogens. But in the word a competitive level, you can expect the word the one questions or maybe the other two questions or the word the some of the chemical properties and the word the physical properties related to which some other group here. Isn't it? Okay. So we are going to identify that one here. Okay. So now we are having one of the drawbacks in the word the periodic table. Can you tell me what is the drawback in the periodic table here? Can you tell me what is the drawback in the periodic table, in the modern periodic table? Have you gone through the periodic table? Okay. That means in that particular periodic table, the hydrogen is placed in the which is the first group, isn't it? Hydrogen is placed in the first group, but actually this shows you what the resembles with the what the first group element and also the which one 17th group elements. If they show the resembles with the what the 17th and also they show the resembles with the first group means what? It does not have the proper position, whether you have to place to the what the first group or whether they have to place to the which one, the 17th group. But actually according to the what the atomic number we are placed in the which is the what the first group. But many of the what the properties, again, even if we are talking about the alkali metals here, because we know that hydrogen is not a which is the metal, actually is a which one? Non-metal. But still it is placed in the which is the first group because of the which one? The atomic, that is the what the number. And now we are going to identify this one. Okay, now see the first concept, what we are going to identify. So now why, that means it is placed in the what the first group and why it cannot be placed in the what the 17th group, even though they shows you what the same set of the properties here. The next thing is about the next concept we are going to identify, the physical and the chemical properties of the which in the hydrogens here. So can you tell me the particular the hydrogens here? So who discovered the hydrogen here? Hydrogen, the discovery of the hydrogen. Anybody? Sometimes, I mean, I'm not telling that it is about the most important thing here. Possibilities are there. In the competitive exam, they may ask, okay, among the following scientists, who discovered the which one? This was the hydrogen. Okay. The scientist, that is the word, the Henry. The Cavendish. The Henry Cavendish who discovered the which is the hydrogen. Okay, the Henry Cavendish. Okay. And now see this one here. And why we are going to call it as the element as the H is why it is called as a which is the hydrogen. The name is given the word to the word the hydrogen element is the word the different. It's a different scientist. Okay. So what is H we are going to call the hydrogen and why it is called as hydrogen? Again, for the word the naming also it is a which is some of the other properties here. Just identify for this one. When you're talking about the word the hydrogen here, I'm talking about the word the hydrogen. Hydro means what? Hydra or hydro, water. Genes means what? Genes means what? Producing. Genes means what? Producing. Just identify this one. So hydro is nothing but the which one? Just identify here. When we're talking about the hydro or hydra is nothing but the which is the water. Isn't it? Is nothing but the which is the water. So now what do you mean by the word the gene? The gene is nothing but the which one? The producing. So I think you have the producing or produces. So what does it produces? Water producing. Why the hydrogen is called as a which is what the this you I mean why the element H is called as hydrogen? Because they are water producing. How does the water forms? Whenever the hydrogen combines with the what the oxygen, that means it undergoes the combustions to give the which one? This is what the water. Okay, let me balance this one here. Hydrogen. See this one. Because of that, we are going to call it as a which is the hydrogen. The name given to the what the H element is the what the different scientist. The element discovered by which one? Henry Cavendish. The name is given by the which is what the Antoni Lavoisier. Heard about this name? Heard about the word the Lavoisier, Antoni Lavoisier. I think in the first year, are familiar about the law of combinations, you're having a different combination. Law of conservation of mass. Again, you're having a law of multiple proportions. Okay. The law of definite proportions. Okay. And there we are going to have the word the one of the word the law. That is the law of conservation of the word the mass. Okay. So that is also the word the particular law was explained by the which the Antoni Lavoisier. Isn't it? Okay. So this is the word the what exactly the word the basic. Information about the hydrogen. Okay, hydrogen is discovered by Henry Cavendish. Okay, and the next thing is, you got the why you got the name. That means you got the element. The H is given as which in the hydrogen, because hydro means what? The water. And genes means what? The producing. Because here is the which one? This is what the water producing element. Okay, that means if you take the what the hydrogen, if you do the what the combustions, what you are going to get? This is what the water. Because of that, the name is given as which on the hydrogen. Okay, are familiar with this concept here? Are familiar with this one? Okay. So now we'll be show the I'll explain the which one the how what are the similarities. The similarities towards which in the what the first group here. So let me move on to the which in the first group here. Okay. Okay, have you written this one? Okay. So see the next one here. So let me move on to the next one here. Resemblance. Resembles with the which one? Alkali metals. You can identify the resembles with the which one the alkali metal. But how does it resembles? Okay, see this one. This is the one, the very very important concept here. The first thing is, you what when you talk about the what the electronic configuration. Electronic configuration. So can you tell me the electronic configurations for the what the lithium? Lithium. Lithium is what? 1s2 2s1, isn't it? 1s2 2s1. Similarly, if you're talking about the which is your the sodium, what are you going to have? 1s2 2s2 2p6. Next thing is what? 3s1. We go for the which is your the next one, the potassium, rubidium, cesium, and the francium here. If you're talking about the outermost electron, 2s1. What is the next outermost electron? 3s1, 4s1, 5s1, 6s1. Okay, so just go this one here. Outermost electrons contains, outermost the orbital contains how many electrons here? The one. The same way, if you're talking about the hydrogen here, what are the electronic configurations here? 1s1. It is having agency about the 1s1. Let's see the next one here. So now, this is the what the particle, the resemblance with the which in the alkali metal, because both the what the hydrogen and the alkali, that is what the metals here. The outermost orbital contains which is what the one electron. That means they were the resembles with the which one? Electronic configurations. Okay, so take the first one here. Resembles with the what the alkali metals here. First one. Both hydrogen and alkali metals have one electrons in the outermost shell. Is it clear? This is the resemblance. Okay, so just take down your the electronic configurations here. Electronic configuration. Okay, next one. The next properties here. The next one is the second one. Electropositive character. Electropositive character. Electropositive character. So what are the outermost electrons?
One electrons.
Okay, just go this one here. Let me take the what the lithium, or if you're talking about which in the sodium ones, it loses how many electron? Only one electron, because the whatever the what the alkali metals you take here, the outermost shell contains only the what the one electron, hence it can loses only how many electrons here? One electrons here. Just identify here. Whenever it loses the what the one electrons here, what is the charge you got here? Positive, Li plus. Similarly, in the sodium also it loses the what the one electrons to give the which is what the Na plus. The same way in the case of in which one? Hydrogen. Hydrogen also loses the how many electrons? One electrons. Can it show the what the electropositive character? Similar to which one? Alkali metals. Okay, let's write down. Electropositive character. So outermost shell contains one electron. Outermost shell contains one electron. Outermost shell contains one electron, and readily loses one electrons to give. And readily loses the one electrons to give. One electrons to give. One electrons to give. Electropositive character. That means they shows you which one the electropositive character. They shows you which one the electropositive character. Is it clear? Okay. Just write on this. So take the next one, the next character. So reaction with non-metals. So or else you can write it as which is the reaction with more electronegative elements. Isn't it? Non-metals, more electronegative. Okay, let's go this one. If we're talking about the sodium, sodium combines with oxygen. What are you going to get? It forms you what the respective. That is you what the oxides. Even the lithium also. Okay, so let me write this one here. This is the what the two. Isn't it? Okay. So similarly, I can go for the which is what the one of the alkali metals reacts with the what the sulfur. What you are going to get? Can you get the sodium sulfide? Whenever the what the sodium reacts with the what the sulfur, elemental sulfur. What do you got here? Sodium sulfide. Okay. Now, the one more non-metals I am going to take. So whenever it reacts with the halogens, you can take the any halogens. Maybe the which is the what the chlorine, fluorine, bromine, or iodine. Here, let me take the what the chlorine. I think you're familiar with this one here. Sodium reacts with the chlorine to form the which one? Sodium chloride, isn't it? Okay, just go this one here. So let me balance the what are these equations here. Okay. Non-metals, oxygen, sulfur, and halogens. As you what here it is what chlorine. Now see the next one here. So suppose what happens when the hydrogen combines with oxygen? It forms the which one? It also reacts to form the what the respective oxide. Here also it forms the respective oxide. That is what the water, isn't it? Similarly, hydrogen combines with the what the elemental sulfur. What does it forms? Hydrogen sulfide. Similarly, hydrogen reacts with the what the chlorine to form the which one? Hydrogen chloride, isn't it? Okay, the similar to the which one the previous one here. Just go this one. Here also it forms sodium chloride. What does it forms? Hydrogen chloride. Sodium sulfide, hydrogen sulfide. Here it is a sodium oxide. There it is a which one? Water. It is nothing but oxides of hydrogen. Okay. So now here you have to balance this one here. It is balanced here. Put a word here. Balance. Okay. Write on this one. Have you done this one? Okay, so the next one here. Liberation at cathode. This is the fourth property, isn't it? Fourth. Okay. Liberation at cathode. Understand for this one. When you take the efficiency for the salt of alkali metals, let me take the sodium chloride. And here I'm going to take the efficiency for the hydrogen chloride. Or you can go for the efficiency for the water also, isn't it? It may be anything here. Okay. So let me take the efficiency for the hydrogen chloride. Now you just do the what the electrolysis process here. When you take the aqueous solution of this one and start doing the electrolysis here, just handy for this one here. When you do the what the electrolysis, that means what you can identify Na plus and the what the Cl minus here. Here also what you are going to get the what the H plus and the what the Cl minus. So we know that when you talk about the what the electrodes here, we're having an anode as well as a which on the cathode. So normally in the electrolytic cell, anode carries what type of the charge? Positive. Cathode carries which is with the negative. Okay. Just identify for this one here. Na plus go move towards the which one? Cathode. Cl minus goes to the which one? Anode. That means here. The chlorine, especially here, chlorine gas is liberated at the which one? Anode. The sodium is deposited at the which one? Cathode. What about in this case? Chlorine gas is liberated at the which one? Anode. Hydrogen gas is liberated at the which one? That is the cathode. Where is the sodium is liberated or the deposited? In the cathode. What about the hydrogen? Cathode. Liberation at the which one? Cathode. Even if you take the which in the water also. If you do the electrolysis for the which one, the acidified water, hydrogen gas is liberated the which one? Cathode. Isn't it? Oxygen gas is liberated the which one? Anode. Okay. So that means both the case, whatever the what the concept you are going to take, okay, especially for the what this one here, on the electrolysis here, that means you have the both hydrogen and that's the what the sodium or the alkali metals, they liberated the which one? That is the what the cathode. This is the resemblance. Okay, right on. Okay, have you done this one? Take the next one here. Reducing character. So normally we know that alkali metals are the which is a strong reducing agent. Okay, especially in the periodic table, the strongest reducing agent is which one? The lithium. The strongest reducing agent is which one? Lithium. The strongest oxidizing agent is which one? Fluorine. Okay, that is, I think you're familiar about the SRP value. Based on the SRP value, okay, we come to know that lower the value of SRP, greater is the which in the reducing character. Higher the value of SRP. SRP is nothing but standard reduction potential. Higher the value of SRP, the greater is the which one? Oxidizing power. Okay. So now we have to prove that the word whether the hydrogen acts as a which in the reducing agent. Just go this one here. Okay. So are you familiar with this one here? Go to this one. Cupric oxide. Whenever it reacts with the what the hydrogen. Sorry, hydrogen here. So what does it give? Here you got the which is what the water, and here you got the which is the copper. Just identify the oxidation state here. Here, what you are having here? Plus 2. Here it is what? 0. Here what do you got here? Plus 1. What do you got here? 0. Now what is reducing agent? What is reducing agent? Or oxidizing agent? Just go to this one here. reducing agent, we can define in the two ways here, the agent which increases its oxidation number, that means their oxidation number should be increased, or else the agent which decreases the oxidation number of the other element, the agent which decreases the oxidation number of the other element, let's go this one, plus 2 to which one? 0. Oxidation number is what? Decreased. Okay, so what is the, what the one more definition here, the agent which increases its oxidation number, so 0 to which one? Plus 1, that means the plus 1, that means the oxidation number is what? Increased. Hence what you are going to call reducing. This reaction explains your the reducing character of which one? Reducing character of which one? Hydrogen. Okay, so that means in this case, this will be the hydrogen act as a which one? Reducing agent. What is the reducing agent? The agent which increases its oxidation number, or as the agent which increases the, what, the oxidation number of the other element in a which one? Redox reaction. Okay, so this reaction explains the which one? The reducing properties of which one? Hydrogen. Reducing properties of hydrogen. I've written this one. Take the next one here. Oxidation state. So what is the oxidation state for the alkali metals or the first group elements? Again, sixth one, no? Sixth property. Okay. Next one is oxidation state. All the first group element, they shows you which one? Plus one oxidation state, isn't it? All the first group elements. Because why they show the plus one? Because the outermost shell contains only which one? One electron. Okay, so write down. Just write your sentence here. Both alkali metals and hydrogen shows. Both alkali metals and hydrogen shows plus one oxidation state. Plus one oxidation state because. outermost shell contains one electron. Outermost shell contains one electron. Is it clear? Okay. So now just go this one here. This is what the resembles with the which one? What the first group elements? Okay. The one thing is. Electronic configuration. What is the next one? So liberation at the which one? Cathode. Next thing is what? Reducing character. Next thing is what? Reaction with the which one? The electronegative or the which one? Reaction with non-metals here. Again, the which one is about the this concept here, the oxidation state. That means the many of the what the property they show the resemblance with the which one, the alkali metals. Okay, so this is the what the resemblance with the alkali metals. So take the next one here. Resembles with halogens. In the bracket 17th group elements. So now you have to identify the which one, that is the what the, how does the what the hydrogen resembles with the which one, the 17th group elements. Again, the same thing we are going to identify. The first one is what? Electronic configuration. So let me write the general electronic configuration for the halogens here. What is the general electronic configuration? Can write NS2NP5. So this is the what the electronic configuration for the which is what the halogens here. Okay. Let me write the electronic configuration for the hydrogen here. What are you going to write? one is just identifier. So both requires only one electrons to obtain the which in the word the noble gas configuration. I mean the word the nearest that is the noble gas configuration. Just identify this. If you write the word the particle of the fluorine here, what is the electronic configuration? 1s2, 2s2, 2p5. What do you require? One electrons to get the nearest noble gas configuration. What is the nearest? Neon. Similarly here also the hydrogen also requires you what the one electrons to get the which one the nearest noble gas configuration, which is that one, helium. So that means electronic configuration, so both halogens and hydrogen requires one electrons to get the which one the nearest noble gas configuration. Okay, so that means they show the resemblance. Okay, so write down both halogens and hydrogen. Both halogens and hydrogens requires one electron to get the nearest noble gas configuration. Okay, just write on this one here. General electronic configuration. This is for the what the halogens. Electronic configurations for the which one the halogens here. NS2, NP5. Okay, and this is the electronic configuration for which one that is the what the hydrogen here. You require only the one electrons to get the nearest noble gas. I've written this one. Okay, so take the next one here. So what are the other properties? The how does it resembles with the which is of the 17 group elements here? Okay, so next thing is what? So what is the second property you written in that one? Electro positive in nature. Okay, now what about here? Electro negative nature. Or electronegative character. It requires how many electrons to get the nearest noble gas? One electron. Say for example, fluorine requires the which is what the one electrons to get the which is the fluoride ion. Similarly, hydrogen also requires the one electrons to get the which is what the hydrogen to get the which one? This is noble gas configurations. Just identify. Can they show you the negative charge? Negative charge here. What about here? This one. Electronegative character means what? Just identify this one here. When you're talking about this one here. So how do you get the which is the word the that is the word the H that is the word the minus? Remember one. This we are going to call as a hydride. This is the which one? Fluoride or the halide ion. Okay. So only when the word the hydrogen combines with the word the metals, they show you what the electronegative. In rest of the conditions, they show you which one electropositive. This concept let remember. Okay, so only in the case of an which is your the metal hydride, they show you what the minus one, or the what the takes up the what the electrons. In rest of the condition, they show you which in the electropositive character. Only with the which in the metals, they show you which one the electronegative character, isn't it? So write down. Both halogens and hydrogen. Hydrogen gains one electron to form halide ion and hydride ion respectively. Hydride ion respectively. Is it clear? Okay, so both will be having the same properties. Okay, so are you familiar about this one here? What is the next one? Reaction with electro positive or the which is what the metals, isn't it? So write down reactions with metals. So let me take the electricity, what the sodium. Let me react with the what the chlorine. What are you going to get? Sodium chloride. Or else you can take the fluorine also. It will be any halogens here. Similarly, if the sodium reacts with hydrogens to form the which one? Sodium hydride. So see this one. Hydride. Here it is halide. Hydride, halide. Here we took the chlorine. And what do you got here? Sodium chloride. This is the what? The sodium hydride. Okay. So write down. Both halogens and hydrogen reacts with metals to form respective halides and hydrides. But here I have to write the name of this product here. Both to form the which on the halides and hydride. What is the name for this one? Sodium chloride. This is the what? The sodium hydride. Hydride. Sodium hydride. Next one, liberation at which one? Anode. Liberation at anode. So let me take the word of this one here. If you do the electrolysis process for the sodium chloride, and let me take the word the electrolysis for the which is sodium hydride. So how does it undergoes dissociation here? Na plus plus Cl minus. Here also Na plus plus H minus. So remember one thing: hydride forms only when the hydrogen combines with which in the metals. In rest of the condition, they shows the which one plus one. Only in the which in the hydride they shows the which on the minus one. Okay, now so electrolysis process means what? Always the anode carries what? Positive charge. Cathode carries the which one? Cathode carries negative charge. So the positive ions move towards the which on the what? The cathode. The negative ions move towards the which is the anode. Remember one thing: in the anode always the reaction is which one? Oxidation, loss of electrons. Cathode is always the which one? Reduction. Is the which one? The gain of electrons. Okay. So now, what can I identify? Can I identify the chlorine gas is liberated at the which in the anode, and the sodium is deposited at the which is what the cathode. What about here? Hydride on oxidation, which liberates which one? Hydrogen gas. And again, this will be the what the C. Isn't it? So this is the what the how we are going to identify the what the particle the what the process here. That means. Liberation at the which is the anode, but the halogen is liberated at the anode, and even the hydrogen is also liberated at the which is what the anode. That means if you do the electrolysis for the which is what their particular the halides and their particular hydrides here, hydrogen gas and the what the halogens that will be liberated at the which one? That is the which one? The anode. Is it clear? Okay, right on. Both liberated at the which one? Anode. Okay, so the next one here. Next property is different from the which is your the first one. Okay, we don't have the property in that one here. Okay, take the next one here. Diatomic molecules. The next one, fifth one is diatomic molecules. So fifth property, isn't it? Okay, diatomic molecules. Both halogens and hydrogen exist as which one? Diatomic molecules. If you see whatever the halogens, we are going to write as which in the F2, Cl2, Br2, and I2. What about the hydrogen? H2, isn't it? Okay. So both halogens and hydrogens exist as a which one? Diatomic molecules. Diatomic molecules, isn't it? I've written this one. Okay. So they exist as a which one? Diatomic molecule. You can go to this one here. F2, Cl2, Br2, and I2. Hydrogen exists as a which one? H2. Hydrogen exists as H2. Okay, so next one, reaction with non-metals. So now you have to identify what happens if the halogens combines with the non-metals. Okay, let me take this some example here. Okay, let's go this one. Okay, so carbon reacts with the chlorine. What are you going to get? Maximum. If you take the excess of the chlorine react with carbon, what are you going to get? Carbon tetrachloride. Okay. Similarly, so whenever the oxygen combines with the chlorine, what are you going to get? Oxygen combines with the chlorine. You are going to get the different oxides: monoxide, trioxide, pentoxide, and the heptoxide. Okay, let me take which is the one of the oxides here, the chlorine monoxide. You may get Cl2O3, Cl2O5, Cl2O7. I take the one of the which in this one here. Okay, so now let me balance this one here. Okay, this will be the two. Here it will be the two, isn't it? Chlorine monoxide. Now what happens if it reacts with the sulfur? Sulfur, or maybe the fluorine here. So let me take the sulfur reacts with the chlorine. So you may get the sulfur hexachloride, or maybe the tetrachloride, isn't it? I think you're familiar with the fluorine, SF4 and SF6. The same thing here. Okay, it reacts with the halogens. I mean the non-metals to give the respective product. Now just go to the next one here. Now what happens if it reacts with the hydrogen? Okay, so let me take this one here. Carbon reacts with hydrogen, what does it give? Can you get the methane? Similarly, oxygen combines with the hydrogen to form the which one? What are you going to get? The water. So this is the particles the process here. And if it reacts with the sulfur, what are you going to get? Respective hydrides. The same concept here. Okay, so this is the particle the reactions what you are going to get here. Okay, so take on this reactions with non-metals. And you can go for the one more reactions here. We know that nitrogen is also a non-metal, reacts with the chlorine here. What you are going to get? It forms NCl3. It does not form the pentalan, isn't it? Because of the absence of d orbital. Okay, so let me balance this one here. Okay, this is the 3. Similarly, if you take the nitrogen combines with hydrogen, what are you going to get? Can you get the ammonia? resembles. So both reacts with the what the halogens, I mean the what the non-metals together, which is your the similar type of the other products here. Okay. So what is the products you can call it? Can you call it as a covalent compounds? Covalent compounds here also you can get the other covalent compounds. How do you get the covalent compounds? The reaction between the which the two non-metals always gives you the covalent compounds. But reaction between the metals and non-metals, what you are going to get? Ionic compound, isn't it? Okay. So you got the which is your the reaction with non-metals is nothing but the which is the formation of which one? Covalent compounds. Okay. Formation of covalent compounds. So next one is oxidizing character. Oxidizing character. I think already I come across the particular reactions here. The sodium reacts with chlorine. What are you going to get? Sodium chloride. Have you got this one? This is funny. Oxygen state is what? 0, 0. What are you? +1, -1. Similarly, sodium reacts with hydrogens to form sodium hydride. This is -1, +1. Here is 0, 0. So what is the oxidizing agent? The agent which decreases its oxidation number or is increase the oxidation number of other element. So this reaction indicates which one? It is an oxidizing character of which one? So next one, oxidation state. So what is the oxidation state for the halogen? Oxidation state. Generally, the halogen they shows you what the -1 oxidation state, but except the what the fluorine, rest of the what the halogen, they shows you the positive oxygen state here, particularly which in the oxides and the oxo acids here. Okay, there we can, and also the interhalogen compound, they show the positive. But generally, what we can say, they shows you which one? -1. The same way here, also, just identify here. Suppose if you want to calculate the oxidation state for this one here, what you are going to get? Can you have the -1? Similarly, they shows you what the -1. Remember one thing here. Hydrogen shows -1 only in which one? Only in which one? Metal hydrides. In rest of the condition, they shows you which one? That is what the +1. Okay, but it is only the one exception because we know that metal always carries positive charge. Hence, the particular element, they have to show the which one? The negative one. Okay, so write down. Generally, halogen shows -1 oxidation state. But hydrogen shows -1 oxidation state only in metal hydrides. only in metal hydrates. Only in which one? Metal hydrates. Okay. Only in metal hydrates. Okay. So this concept let remember here. Only in the metal hydrate the hydrogen shows minus one. In rest of the condition they shows you which one? Plus one. Is it clear? Okay. Just go this one. It shows you what the so many resembles with the what the 17th group and also with the which is the first group elements. But it does not guess you what the best positions in the which is you what the periodic table. Because of that, so it is called as a which is the notorious element. Why the hydrogen is called as a notorious element? Because they shows you what the resembles with both alkali metals as well as a which one halogens here. Because of that, what you are going to call it is a notorious element. Okay, so just write a note here. Just a note. So hydrogen is called as notorious element or the rogue elements, rogue, rogue elements, because they shows the resembles with which one? Alkali metals and also halogens. So because of that, what you are going to call? They are going to call it as a which one? Notorious or the which one? The rogue elements. Okay. Sometimes they are going to among the following, which one is notorious elements? Okay. Which is that one? Is a hydrogen? We are going to call it as a which one? Notorious. The reason is which one? Resembles with the which in the alkali metal, the first group, and also the which in the what the 17th group elements. Okay, so now see the differ here. Hydrogen is a which one? The non-metal, but all the alkali metals are which one? Metals. They are highly reactive metals. Okay, there is a differ, but based on the which in the atomic number, we are going to place it in the which in the first group. Okay, but majority we can identify the resembles with the 17th one. If you see the properties here, so there also they show the some resembles with the alkali. But majority they shows you which is your the 17th group. Okay, one more thing is see which one they exist as a diatomic molecules, just similar to which one? Halogens. Okay, all the halogens are the which in the diatomic, that is your the molecule. Okay, the first two will be the what the gas, fluorine and the chlorine is a gas, bromine is a volatile liquid, iodine is a which in the volatile, that is a solid, isn't it? Okay, so this is related to the what the particles you what the resembles with first and the what the 17th one. Okay, so take the next one here, isotopes. Next subheading, isotopes. Isotopes of hydrogen. Okay. So now, especially in this isotopes here, we are having three isotopes. Which are the three isotopes here? The one thing is the normal hydrogen. Next thing is what? Deuterium. Next thing is which one? As you what the tritium. Okay. So that is you what the what you can add your protium. We are going to call it as a normal hydrogens here. The ordinary hydrogen. This is what the protium, deuterium, and tritium. These are the which in the three that is your the isotopes here. And now we are going to identify the properties here. Okay. So related to the which is your the isotopes here. Okay. I'll come in your the next class here. Okay. But one more thing here. In the what the periodic table, the different element they shows the different isotopes. But isotopic effect is shown only by which one? Hydrogen. We can't identify the isotopic effects in the other different ones. So what exactly are the isotopic effects here? That means there is a which is what the increases in the which is what the particle the what the mass. So especially when you're talking about the carbon 12, carbon 13, and carbon 14 here, from 12 to 13. So see the mass. From 13 to which is the 14, but what about in the what the what the isotopes of the what the hydrogens here? The mass is increased with the two, that is the two times, again the three times, 1 to 2, again from 1 to 3, that is 2 times and the 3 times, there is a sudden increase in the which in the what the mass, but we can't identify the what the sudden increase in the what the mass as in the case of the rest of the what the elements and their isotopes. Is it clear? The isotopic effect is shown only by which one? Hydrogen. Okay, the rest of the element they show the isotopes, but not the which one? Isotopic effects. Okay, related to that one, I'll come into the next class. Okay, are you familiar with the today's class here? Okay, now one thing is what? Just this is the general information here. You have to remember the which one? Who discovered the which is what the hydrogen? This is which in the Henry Cavendish. And next thing is the Wittgenstein water. The name is given to the what the element H is by the Wittgenstein, the Antoni Lavoisier. Why he gave the what the number? I mean the name as a hydrogen, because hydro means what the water, and the genes means what the producing. There is a water producing element. Because of that, he gave the what the name as a Wittgenstein, the hydrogen. Okay. Next thing is what the resembles with the which one first group as well as the which one 17th group here. Okay. In that case, sometimes they may ask the what the reducing character. So sometimes they may ask in the which one you what the one more the properties here. That is you what the oxidation state. Okay. So possibilities are there by knowing that one. So sometimes they're going to give the out of the four options here, they're going to indicate among the what the following, okay, which one shows you what the resembles with the alkali metal. They're changing the particular property. So based on that one, you have to identify. Is it clear? Okay. So if I'm looking at today's class here. Okay. So next class, I'm going to explain the which one, the isotopes, and also this further the properties of hydrogen. Okay. I'll continue next class.